Lots of people play games on integrated GPUs, while serious gamers love to say that no one in their right mind will game on an integrated. Their ubiquity makes them likely candidates when you have no other option or are on a really low budget, especially considering how good some integrated GPUs are getting. But here's a question that has caused fights in a lot of my comment sections and that has gotten people to send me some really angry messages. How important is RAM speed on integrated GPUs? When you look at the theory of how a GPU works, it makes sense. In super simplified means, the CPU sends the GPU instructions and data on what it needs to render. On a dedicated GPU, there is specialized RAM included, VRAM, that stores the texture, shadow maps, and anything else that the GPU needs to render, and also stores the frame buffer with the finished frames. So bigger textures, more complex shadows, or triple buffering require GPUs with more VRAM. Because of this, if you have a dedicated GPU with enough VRAM, you can get away with ludicrously slow RAM that will make load times significantly longer, but the games will work okay once loaded. But an integrated GPU has no VRAM, and so the system assigns dynamically a part of the regular old RAM as VRAM, and that means that if your RAM is slow, you can potentially run into lower performance not because the GPU is slow, but because it has to wait too long to get data from the RAM for every frame. But how big is this effect really? To find out, I took my delicious new Athlon APU, which uses some really good integrated Vega graphics, and a ton of RAM, all at different speeds to see how much of a difference it will make over 3 games. CSGO on 720, for the older spectrum, Far Cry 5 on the vanilla lowest settings for a new game, and why not, GTA 5 on 720 with the tweaked super low config file for better performance. Also, as a bonus data, let's use Blender. Blender is a free open source 3D modeling program that is widely used worldwide and that provides an easy to use free benchmark that simulates the rendering of a scene and that can stress the GPU quite heavily. And if you want to become an expert in 3D modeling in Blender, I can point you to some excellent premium courses in Skillshare, this video sponsor, but I can already feel some of you going for the skip button, so I will leave that for later. Don't worry, Skillshare will come. You can't escape.
You will be educated for a reasonable fee.
Part 1, dual channel versus single channel. All of these RAM sticks can be run on the same speed, but this is 8 gigs in one stick, and this is 8 gigs in two 4 gigs stick for dual channel. Using a dual channel kit, which includes two sticks, provides more channels of communication, so you get better reading speeds, even though the speed of each stick is the same. And I think they're kits for 3 or 4 channels, but I have never seen any of those in real life because I will never be able to afford one of those motherboards. But believe me, you will notice the difference between dual and single channel. The effect on CSGO is not as dramatic, but more bandwidth heavy games like Far Cry 5 or the memory intensity that is the GTA 5 benchmark set differences in like 30 to 20%. If there's one thing that I want you to take away from this video for sure, is that dual channel on integrated GPUs makes a big difference. In Blender, there's also a difference, with about 10 minutes shaved from the rendering time. Nothing mind-blowing, but some parts of the rendering process were definitely limited by a memory bandwidth. Part 2, dual channel. I tested on 3 different RAM speeds, and there are several points that are important to comment. First, the 2133MHz dual channel, the slowest speed that I tested, actually did better than 2400MHz in a single channel. If you have to decide between slower dual channel RAM and faster single channel, better to go with the slow dual channel. Second, I wish I could tell you it is as simple as if RAM being 20% faster means 20% more frames, but games are complicated, and memory bandwidth is just one component in the big machine that is a GPU. For example, CSGO and Far Cry 5 are not as bandwidth intensive as Grand Theft Auto, which has the giant map that needs to be streamed in the middle of the benchmark, so the performance of CSGO and Far Cry is not as affected when jumping from 2133 to 2400. And you finally see a decent jump on 2666, the max compatible RAM speed for this Athlon. GTA 5 does okay in 2133, but really jumps on 2400, and it kinda stays there. So, what did I learn from this? Yeah, if you want the best performance, you have to use the fastest RAM, big surprise. But as long as you avoid single-channel RAM, like the plague, there can be a bit of a sweet spot for certain games. If you're playing something that involves moving rapidly through big worlds, you're likely going to do better with a bit more memory bandwidth, and it will depend a lot on your country too. In my case, paradoxically, I see the fastest RAM kit as cheaper. How does this make any sense is beyond me. But if in your country 2400 MHz is vastly cheaper than 2666 MHz, you can get away with it as long as it's dual channel. How expensive is a dual channel 8GB kit in the street speeds in your country? Let me know, I'm really curious. Blender sees mixed results? Sometimes render times go slightly higher on faster RAM, which likely means that memory bandwidth is no longer the main concern for this sort of productivity. So, your main concern if using software like this is going dual channel rather than just faster RAM. But if your concern is that you do not know how to use Blender at all, the solution is easy. You know what it is, it's Skillshare, the premium website for 20,000 classes in design, business, technology, including many courses on many levels for Blender. So if you want to start creating models for a video game or for an animation, or you're just curious of how to get started, the link in description will get you 2 months of unlimited access for free while supporting the channel. Thank you to Skillshare for continuously allowing this channel to be awesome, and you for watching, commenting, giving ideas, Patreon, Discord, sending me emails. Just don't send me emails if your computer's broken, expecting me to fix it. You're free to say hi, though. I should have cut this outro a while ago. Why am I still talking? I know, let me hide a really bad joke here. What is Sonic the Hedgehog's favorite season? Spring.